Couple days ago, my 5-year-old granddaughter, Zelda, was visiting, and she asked my son to print her out a picture that she could color. She likes coloring, and you can find coloring pictures online all the time. So she asked him to print it out. Now, most 5-year-old girls would probably want to have a picture of a kitten or a unicorn or something, but this is what Zelda had Lincoln print out for her to color. This is the cute picture she wanted. Maybe she was thinking, hey, it's a small fuzzy animal. It's cute, right? But this is what, now you can see it's not actually colored. And that's because before she could start coloring it, I came home and she wanted to mess around with me and my wife instead of coloring pictures. But she does know these are scary on some level because she took it and she tried to scare me with the picture. So of course, I was really scared and she liked that a lot. Anyway, just thought I mentioned that in passing. So I get nightmares a lot. Probably this is due to the fact I read scary books and I watch scary movies and I spend a lot of time obsessed about creepy topics. Now, when I'm actually in the nightmare, I am just as unhappy and, you know, worried about it as anyone else. It's not fun. But when I wake up, I think back to the nightmare and sometimes I get some pretty cool ideas from them. In fact, I would say that a major source of my creative juices is actually from those nightmares. I find it interesting that H.P. Lovecraft also had a lot of nightmares, and famously many of his creations come from nightmares. I'm not saying that creatively I am like Lovecraft. I'm just saying that we both had nightmares and both were able to use them in our activities. Let me give you a few examples of my nightmares and how I turned them into productive efforts. Back in 1994, I had a horrifying nightmare in which I was in a weird underground cavern, partly man-made. I had to move over and descend these slender bridges and ledges over a bottomless chasm. Something was chasing me. I never got a good look at it in the dream, and so I had to hurry. But there was rickety structures and incredibly narrow walkways made it even more terrifying. I had to back along the walls like this because it was so narrow. I'm a little afraid of heights, so that probably factored into the terror. But the dark underground nature of the huge area, which extended off into the darkness every which way, reminded me when I woke up of Lovecraft's underground caverns. Now, at the time, my job was to create maps for Doom 2. So when I went to work that day, I promptly started on map 24 of Doom 2, which I named the Chasm, and I made it look as much as possible like my nightmare. Now, I couldn't reproduce everything in Doom's crude 3D, really 2D and a half format. For one thing, I couldn't have the ledges slanting downward ever downward. I couldn't have the bridges have empty space underneath them. And I couldn't reproduce the thing that was chasing me very well. But I did the best I could. I think it's a pretty creepy level. In addition to this, I have recurring nightmares. One is about the giant termite. Thank heavens that one finally stopped happening. I haven't dreamed about that creature in years. Decades, really, but it plagued me in my youth. But another is a dream where I'm in a building, sometimes a public library, sometimes my grandfather's house. But when I'm in this, at some point, I find that the building has a secret room in a corner somewhere. It's cramped, triangular, and it's always lit by an eerie yellow light. In the room, there's always a cobwebbed desk and stacks of moldy old books and other such bric-a-brac. Sitting at the desk is always a withered corpse. As I move towards the corpse, it turns around slowly, and while I'm frozen with fear, it reaches a hand towards my face. So far, I've always awakened just as it touches me. So far. Anyway, this awful thing, which I dream about at least every year, every couple of years since I was in high school, has played a major role in how I think about undead. Instead of rotting gelatinous zombies, my mental concept of an undead is a dried, mummied thing that is fully intelligent, but wholly maligned. After all, the desiccated horror in my nightmare is sitting at a desk. He has books and stuff. He's hiding in a secret chamber of a larger building. So, when it came time to create an undead monster for my Cthulhu Wars game, I didn't want a zombie. I wanted something like my nightmare. I did have my artist give it mummy wrappings, while the creature in my night dreams wears a dusty, threadbare suit. Anywhere, I'm sure my pet undead will continue to show up in future dreams and future games. Even more recently, I had a dream this very March, 2019, in which an alien creature was trying to conquer the Earth. I was seeing it in the news on TV. The creature was a Broodmaster, the same one that I used in my game Hyperspace. Now, I created the idea of the Broodmasters when I was just 13 years old, and so it's been, I guess, part of my subconscious all along. Though I don't remember any previous nightmares ever about this creature, but this one had the Broodmaster in the news. There was news footage of killed broodlings like giant ticks. Guys are holding it up on the screen. Look, I got this. And there was troops fighting broodlings. It looked like the war in Syria. You'd see guys shooting in the background. They said those broodlings over there were shelling them, you know. And there was other supporting features to the dream. I do remember thinking, whoa, I thought about the broodmasters when I was a kid. I guess maybe it was a mental implant from the brood, and that's why they're real. It was actually a real thing all along. I remember thinking that. NASA had a special on TV where they said that the main broodmaster had a base on the moon, and space authorities were trying to recreate the Saturn V rocket, the biggest rocket ever made, with a nuclear warhead for striking at it. So it was a pretty specific dream. Now, while I was listening to the news in my dream, I heard something in my basement, and when I went downstairs, there was a larva broodmaster there covered with his little parasite-like broodlings. Somehow, I knew it was a larva, even though it was like 3 or 4 feet across. Now, when I woke up, this last part kind of puzzled me because my house doesn't have a basement. So, oh well. Anyway, but then the very next night after the nightmare about the brood invading Earth, I had a dream, not a nightmare, in which I was designing a game about the brood master invading Earth. I was working out units, I was creating the map, I was figuring out rules. And so when I woke up from that dream, I went ahead and created the game. I'm hoping to release the game sometime next year, but it came completely from these dreams. I even incorporated rules that I made up in the design dream into the actual game. So nightmares have helped me, but I guess they also have made me sad sometimes. And since 'tis the season, Halloween and all, I'll end with two of the worst nightmares I ever had, which are kind of oddball ones. First, let me say that I know when I've been working too long on a project, because I start dreaming about working on that project. Back in 1995, I had a dream in which I was the hero in Doom. I'm running through a level. I'm being chased by these big elephant-like monsters, not anything from the actual game Doom, something new. And in one part of the dream, I'm running along, and I came across a river of lava. There was a bridge over it, so I ran over the bridge and kept going. I thought to myself, huh, that was easy. Good thing there was a bridge. Later on in the dream, as I raced around the level trying to avoid or kill the monsters, I, as you do in Doom, you kind of come back to the same areas again and again. I came back to the lava river, but the bridge was gone. This time I had to jump over the lava. At that point in the dream, I realized I wasn't just a character in the Doom universe. I was actually playtesting a level. I was the guy testing a Doom level while the designer, who I knew was me, Sandy Petersen, was sitting at a computer changing and adjusting the level to make it harder for me to survive. I was the villain of my own dream. It was Sandy versus Sandy. It sounded pretty funny to me when I woke up, but in the dream, realizing that the level was going to keep getting harder and harder as Sandy made changes, it was pretty awful. So I guess we are our own worst enemy. Now, for the last nightmare I wanted to mention, this happened just a few months ago. So one of my recurring nightmares, I did mention I have these, is giant spiders. Now, it's not just giant spiders that appear. It's more subtle. What happens is that at first, I'm having some ordinary dream, whatever it is, okay? And there's some normal-sized spiders. You know, they'll be in the corner of the room, they'll be under the refrigerator, wherever they are, they're spiders, right? And then as the dream progresses, no matter what the main idea of the dream is, spiders keep showing up. But every time they show up, they're a little bigger and sometimes more numerous. So far, the biggest I've seen in one of these dreams is about a 3-foot lake span, but that was pretty bad. Usually I wake up before they're that big, typically when they're maybe the size of a baseball or so, you know. Anyway, so I was having a dream a few months ago, and I had to fix something in my basement, which I said I don't have a basement. I don't know why I keep dreaming about basements. I literally have not had a basement in any of the places I've lived in my entire life. Maybe I'm remembering my grandpa's basement. I don't know. Anyway, there were spiders in the basement, and I was trying to fix things. And as the dream progressed, new, ever bigger spiders kept showing up. There was black widows the size of ping pong balls, you know, and wool spiders the size of my leg span, the size of my hand, that kind of thing. Anyway, so I'm down there, and I'm telling myself the spiders aren't dangerous, you know. And I opened up a panel in a wall to fix a water heater or something. I don't remember. And hanging on the inside of this panel were a pair of ginormous spiders. Their bodies were at least 6 inches long. Of course, I like immediately shut the panel. Then I started thinking, remember, this is all still in the dream. I'm thinking in the dream, maybe this is a dream. Spiders that big aren't real. They can't be real. Spiders don't get that big. I'm going to open the panel. And if those huge spiders are still there, I'll know this is a dream and I don't have to be scared anymore. So I opened the panel again, and the two giant spiders that I had seen just a second ago were now plastic toy spiders hanging from a hook. I stayed in the dream for a while. Later, I woke up. But think about this. In the dream, I figured out the spiders might not be real. But my brain, for some reason, wanted to keep me in the dream. So it turned the spiders into plastic. So I'd stay in the dream with the having the dream with the big spiders. You know, not right. Why did my brain do this? Why did it want me to stay there? I think my brain is not my friend.